Hello and welcome. Today, we'll be taking a look at how to work with lists in Tabs3 Billing. Using the Tabs3 Billing lists makes it easy to view clients, contacts, fees, costs, payments, client funds, and write-offs without having to run a report. These lists can be filtered to only show information that is important to you and makes performing actions on these records simple. Let's say that you want to see a list of all active clients for a specific primary timekeeper that have been added in the last 6 months. Start by searching for clients using the Quick Launch. A list of clients will be displayed. Using a customizable quick view, our list has already been filtered to only show active clients for timekeeper 1 added in the last 6 months. You can easily toggle to a different quick view or turn a quick view off from the Quick Clicks pane. Quick Clicks provide convenient access to many features that affect list functionality, including quick views, filters, column layouts, and more. For more information about specific features available in the Quick Clicks pane, check out the Using Quick Clicks video. Additional information about quick views can be found in the Using Quick Views video. Each list will include actions specific to the list in the Take Action area. For example, the Clients list includes the option to add a transaction, generate a statement for the selected matter, or to add a new client. By double-clicking on an item in the list, you can edit information about the record. Additionally, selecting the client ID will open the Matter Manager. Let's add a new client. Just click Add Client and select the client ID to use. Once you enter new information for the client, click Save and return to the list. Now, let's look at a list of all fees added in the last week by a specific user. Search for fees in the Quick Launch. You'll notice that the list is currently sorted by client ID. However, if you want to see the list sorted by date, simply click on the Date column header. You can also control what columns are included in the list using a column layout. By adding or editing an existing column layout, you can select the columns relevant to you and decide what order that they'll appear in. By selecting a column in the list, you can perform an incremental search by typing in the information you need to find in that column. Additionally, you can easily search the displayed list for specific information using the search box. Another feature that the fee and cost lists include is the option to easily change the status of one or more transactions from print to hold or vice versa. This can save you time when you need to change the status of multiple records before billing. Simply select the transaction in the list and click Set Status to Print. The fee will automatically be adjusted. You can easily toggle between work in process and build fees using the links in the Quick Clicks pane. Additionally, you can copy any information from the list by highlighting the records and copying them to Excel. To select all the displayed records, simply press Ctrl+A on your keyboard. Then, press Ctrl+C to copy. Then, just paste the information into Excel. In the Quick Clicks pane, you can also run reports specific to the list that you're viewing or customize the way that each list looks using list preferences. And that's all it takes to work with lists in Tabs3 Billing. For more information, check out our help topics by clicking the question mark icon on the toolbar. Thanks for watching. See you next time.